Hey guys, that's right. We just dropped our brand new ANA merch. We got two designs for you guys. We got our classic ANA logo so you can watch our videos in style. And then we have our Getting Lost in the Sauce with some banging cosmic headphones. You can get both of these shirts right down below. Just go and scroll down and grab them. And with that, back to today's video.
Hey guys, hope you're having a great day. It was a great life.
Great life. We are back. Dude,
some more
Who?
The Who? It's just so exciting. The past three songs, didn't we give them three back-to-back tens?
I think so. I think so far they've clapped back pretty hard at us. Like, we're trying to not give them a 10 because at this point, we're what, 0-3 to them?
Yeah.
If this was a fight, we would be
losing
out of commission.
Harshly. They just keep. And we asked, what's the 4 of 10? And there were multiple comments, all of them having hundreds of likes each one, but like a total of like 800 likes worth saying that we need to do this song.
So, you know what? Like I said, community driven, you guys are the ones that dictate it. So we're doing Love Rain Over Me.
This the 10? Let's do it, dude.
Yeah, let's do it. That being said, before we get into it, make sure you hit a subscribe, notification bell, because new setup, new year, new ANA community, we got to make that happen.
All that good stuff. Let's dive into it, dude.
I love how the drums float in the piano in the back. That's so well orchestrated. Like raindrops.
Only love can make it rain. The way the beach gets kissed by the sea. Only love can make it rain. Like the sweat of lovers laying in the field.
Thank you. way too good.
Dude.
Oh.
I just.
Yeah. Dude, that's in the same league as something like Stairway to Heaven to me.
Yeah.
Like, in the way that it's like a ballad that I didn't know they could do, but also powerful.
Yeah.
Emotionally charged.
Like, I love how the song started, like how they just initially came in, how they built it up, and then when the song initially, like, actually started, for a second I was like, I don't think it's a 10 for me, like, at the moment, you know? Yeah, yeah. And then they quickly shut my mind up, very quickly, just with all the arrangement, the vocals, dude, the Keith Moon on the drums, just all of it.
Yeah, everything was great. Everything was great. I loved the instrumentation at the beginning, the arrangement of it. I mentioned it quietly. I don't know if you caught it, but basically the way that the drums melded into the piano, which kind of mimicked each other, mm-hmm. and then they kind of came together, and it came back separately again, where then it was just drums again, and then it ended up being more piano. And it was like, just flowed so seamlessly into everything else. That was just masterful arrangement.
Wow.
And like you were saying, the drumming was absolutely phenomenal.
Oh, yeah. And the guitar work too, because like after all this cascading stuff in the middle section, like when it kind of calmed down a little bit,
and even like the just, jangly acoustic stuff, just driving, just very tasteful. Yeah. Everything was tastefully done.
That lead work though, dude. Like I'm just so I'm gonna have to like listen to it like heavily now. Just
I don't
want to like jump the gun and say some of my favorite like lead guitar work I've ever heard, but like it's up there. It's just so it was so smooth. Like in terms of a like guitar playing lead in a ballad.
Yeah.
That's it, dude.
Yeah.
Just it was
because there's like angst and emotion to it. It's not just like, oh, I'm playing guitar because it fits. It's like I'm playing what is literally perfect here.
It's
vocal work's phenomenal. I mean, like literally insane. Like that to me is like should be in like the pinnacle of like rock and roll vocal achievements. Where it's like, if you think of like, dude, quintessential rock and roll vocals, like
the who is there.
One note, like, has to be there.
Yeah.
Dang, dude.
Just
10.
10. 10.
Gotta give it up.
There was a moment where I was like, I'm gonna find a reason not to give it a 10. But then, like, there were too many moments where I was like, there's no way I could even begin to attempt to sit up here and act like it's not a 10. There's just no way.
Like,
there's no way.
I was trying my best to like also think of like critiques. Like when you get a band that's this good,
it's hard.
Yeah, it's like, what are the nitpicks I could find?
It's like,
and I didn't see any in this one.
It's like, what are you?
I don't know. Maybe we're wrong. We're just two guys.
Well, obviously there's somebody who doesn't like it, you know.
Yeah. Well,
somebody.
I want to know. Like maybe there's something that I didn't hear on the first listen. Tell us in the comments what you guys think. Like, try to find a criticism in it. Like, what did you not like about it? What's something that you think could be better?
Just
give us some more ammo to come at them.
I just feel like they had records, dude, that you just threw on, you sat back, and you didn't not have a good time.
Yeah, I mean, this was
just
something else.
That's the who, man.
Oh, that being said,
first week done of our new setup, dude.
Dang.
Just. Tell us
how
you guys like it. Like, is it better than the old one? Did you like the black sheet?
Because we did not. We're thinking about getting a P.O. box. We've had a bunch of people say they want to send us stuff. So maybe we'll start putting knickknacks up on the wall. Maybe we'll get some. We'll figure it out. But you guys let us know what you guys want to do. I mean, it's your channel as much as our channel. We want to make this big-ass family. Get lost in the sauce together while we listen to music and sip whiskey.
Facts. Whiskey is also the important part.
Yeah. Got a decanter. Yep. Anyways, you know what's up. We'll catch you next week.
Yep.
See ya.